Let us now pray the Oratio Imperata for protection against COVID-19. Please all kneel. Merciful and compassionate Father, we come to you in our need to seek your protection against the COVID-19 that has disturbed and claimed many lives. We ask you now to look upon us with love and by your healing hand, dispel the fear of sickness and death, restore our hope, and strengthen our faith. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. We thank you for the vaccines developed, made possible by your guiding hands. Bless our efforts to use these vaccines to end the pandemic in our country. We pray for our health workers that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. Grant them health in mind and body, strength in their commitment, protection from the disease. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Give us the grace in these trying times to work for the good of all and to help those in need. May our concern and compassion for each other see us through this crisis and lead us to conversion and holiness. Grant all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and blessed Virgin. Amen. Our Lady, health of the sick,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel,
pray for us.
San Roque,
pray for us.
San Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
San Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us. Good afternoon, brothers and sisters. Please stand as we begin our Eucharistic celebration. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, as we celebrate this Eucharist, let us open our hearts to the inspiration and the movement of the Spirit as we listen to God's Word and as we receive communion in Jesus' body and blood. To prepare ourselves to celebrate this Holy Mass, let us first acknowledge our sins and humbly ask the Lord for His pardon and mercy. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. God of might, giver of every good gift, put into our hearts the love of your name, so that by deepening our sense of reverence, you may nurture in us what is good, and by your watchful care, keep safe what you have nurtured. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the first letter of Saint Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, the Spirit scrutinizes everything, even the depths of God. Among men, who knows what pertains to the man except his spirit that is within? Similarly, no one knows what pertains to God except the Spirit of God. We have not received the spirit of the world, but a spirit who is from God, so that we may understand the things freely given us by God. And we speak about them, not with words taught by human wisdom, but with words taught by the Spirit, describing spiritual realities in spiritual terms. Now, the natural man does not accept what pertains to the Spirit of God, for to him it is foolishness, and he cannot understand it, because it is judged spiritually. The one who is spiritual, however, can judge everything, but is not subject to judgment by anyone. For who has known the mind of the Lord so as to counsel him? But we have the mind of Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is just in all his ways.
The Lord is just in all his ways.
The Lord is gracious and merciful, slow to anger and of great kindness. The Lord is good to all and compassionate toward all his works.
The Lord is just in all his ways.
Let all your works give you thanks, O Lord, and let your faithful ones bless you. Let them discourse of the glory of your kingdom and speak of your might.
The Lord is just in all his ways,
making known to men your might and the glorious splendor of your kingdom. Your kingdom is a kingdom for all ages, and your dominion endures through all generations.
The Lord is just in all his ways.
The Lord is faithful in all his words and holy in all his works. The Lord lifts up all who are falling and raises up all who are bow down.
The Lord is just in all his ways. Please stand.
A great prophet has arisen in our midst, and God has visited his people.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus went down to Capernaum, a town of Galilee. He taught them on the Sabbath, and they were astonished at his teaching, because he spoke with authority. In the synagogue, there was a man with the spirit of an unclean demon, and he cried out in a loud voice, "What have you to do with us, Jesus of Nazareth? Have you come to destroy us? I know who you are, the Holy One of God." Jesus rebuked him and said, "Be quiet, come out of him." Then the demon threw the man down in front of them and came out of him without doing him any harm. They were all amazed and said to one another, "What is there about his word? For with authority and power, he commands the unclean spirits, and they come out." And news of him spread everywhere in the surrounding region. Brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
My dear brothers and sisters, in our readings today, we hear the connection between the Word and the Spirit. The readings today teach us that whatever word comes out of us comes from the Spirit within. Kaya po magandang sa araw na ito, bantayan nga po natin ano ba ang lumalabas na salita sa bibig natin. Kasi sabi sa mga pagbasa ngayon, anuman ang salitang lumalabas sa iyo, galing yan sa Espiritong nasa loob mo. So it is good that we observe ourselves and take attention also and see what words come out of us so that we could see what spirit is inside us. In our first reading today from the letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians, this is what St. Paul teaches the community in Corinth. Saint Paul said, "What we have spoken to you are not words taught by human wisdom, but our words are taught by the Spirit of God. Saint Paul connects the words that come out of us to the Spirit where the words come from. And Saint Paul teaches the Christians in Corinth that we should learn from the Spirit of Jesus, so that whatever words that come out of us should come from the Spirit of God. The example of this is our gospel passage today. We see two characters in our gospel passage. One is the person with an unclean demon, unclean spirit in him. And the other one is Jesus. What is the difference between them? The man with an unclean spirit is shouting. He was wailing loudly. And his words are not words that inspire, but words that destroy. He was saying fake news against Jesus. Sabi niya, "What have you to do with us, Jesus of Nazareth? Have you come to destroy us?" Sinisiraan niya si Jesus. Sabi niya, "Alam kong dumating ka dito para puksain kami, to destroy us." That is fake news. Because Jesus came not to destroy us, but to save us. That is why Jesus told him, "Be quiet. You are telling lies and fake news." So be careful, ah. If you are sharing fake news on social media, alam mo na, hindi Espiritu ni Jesus ang gumagana sa'yo. Espiritu ng demonyo ang gumagana. Kapag puro fake news, puro chismis, puro kasinungalingan ang lumalabas sa iyo. We can see the difference of Jesus. The people were amazed and astonished when they heard Jesus speak. They said, "His words are full of authority," meaning full of truth and not lies. Your word is connected with the Spirit working in you. That is why the word inspire means to breathe the Spirit, inspirare, to breathe the Spirit within. Let us make sure that our words inspire and breathe the Spirit of God and not destroy and breathe the spirit of the devil. Mga minamahal na kapatid, sa araw na ito, tinuturuan tayo ni Jesus na bigyang halaga ang salita natin. Bigyang pansin ano ang lumalabas sa bibig natin. Kasi kung anong lumalabas sa bibig natin ay nagpapakita yan ano ang espiritong kumikilos sa loob natin. As we continue our celebration of the Mass, we thank the Lord that we have listened this afternoon to God's Word. Let the word of Jesus that we have heard in this Mass breathe into us the Spirit of Jesus, so that in turn, in the inspiration of the Spirit, we can breathe out through our words the Spirit of God. Amen.
Please stand.
Through the gospel, Christ speaks to us with words of eternal authority and deeds of healing power. Through him, let us pray with confidence. For every petition, let us say, Holy One of God, bless us.
Holy One of God, bless us.
That the Church may continue to teach Christ's truth and combat the evils of our time, let us pray to the Lord.
Holy One of God, bless us.
That world leaders may promote righteousness in their governments and be zealous in eradicating evils in the societies they are sworn to serve, let us pray to the Lord.
Holy One of God, bless us.
That we may not grow idle in our prayer life, so that the unclean spirits may not take over our lives, let us pray to the Lord.
Holy One of God, bless us.
That the sick and those who suffer may be freed from their bodily or spiritual afflictions, let us pray to the Lord.
Holy One of God, bless us.
That the faithful departed may enjoy the radiant dawn of eternal life, let us pray to the Lord.
Holy One of God, bless us.
Heavenly Father, we rejoice in your abundant love for us. Establish your authority within us and be our companion on the road of life. We make our prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. Please stand.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy Church.
May this sacred offering, O Lord, confer on us always the blessing of salvation, that what it celebrates in mystery, it may accomplish in power. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in love. His resurrection we confess with living faith. and his coming in glory, we await with unwavering hope. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end, we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us now offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Brothers and sisters, the body of Christ.
Amen.
Act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Sacramento banal na kahal. Please stand.
Let us pray. Renewed by this bread from the heavenly table, we beseech you, Lord, that being the food of charity, it may confirm our hearts and stir us to serve you in our neighbor. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless all of you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth. The Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Pusong dalis ay dakila,
Thank you.